For me, I always wanted to be in the church. And when they asked me if I wanted to be a monk, I immediately said yes. Perhaps I was not aware of the meaning of living in a monastery. I wasn't aware of what it meant, but I knew that I wanted to have an spiritual life for the rest of my life. Perhaps I was not that attracted to family life, because I didn't have a big family, neither I had my father and my mother were not divorced, but they lived in a different place because my father was a cardiologist, so he was always working in a hospital in a different city. And my mother, she had her own work, and she was not at home. So I didn't experience having a large family, brothers and sisters, father and mother, my grandparents. So I think for me it was a normal thing to become a monk. But for a regular person to live a spiritual life, how does that relate to the life of a monk? I think it's the same thing, because I consider, especially in Russian Orthodoxy, a lay person has to live the life, his spiritual life, like a monk. That doesn't mean that he is committed to be praying all day, but he has to fast, he has to have a life of prayer morning and evening, and he has to live his life around the calendar, because we Orthodox need to watch the calendar and see today is a Wednesday, today is a Friday, so it's a fast day. This week was a fast free, but then we know that Great Lent is approaching. It's here, it's almost here, and I don't see the life of a lay person different than the life of a monk, because the life of a lay person also has to be celibacy before his marriage in the church. So if a person is really into his faith, into the Orthodox faith, if he's living in a spiritual life, he will be very similar to a monk. But a monk will have to dress differently, of course. He has different roles, especially obedience. Obedience and humility. This is our main task in life, that we have to obey, because the church is a hierarchical institution, but we need to obey. In the monastery, well, I am the abbot, and so all the monks have to obey what I say. But honestly, I don't give orders to anybody. They know what they have to do. We have our bylaws, the monastic constitution, and they have to read it at least once a week, so they know if they are doing the right thing. But they have to come for confession, so I know the struggles in their spiritual life, in their lives. I have to supervise them, I have to visit them, where they live, because we have all these kids in the monasteries. And I think I have a very close relationship with every monk. But I myself have my spiritual father. I also have a spiritual father. And I also have to obey my spiritual father, but not only my spiritual father, I have to obey my bishop. And I have to report whatever I do to the bishop. So our lives are normal lives, but well organized. And I think that we monastics cannot live a life of wasting our time. We know that it is important that we do everything today. Yesterday it's gone, and tomorrow we don't know. We will see. So I don't know if this responds to your question, but I think that any